semplice. Infatti, per mia fortuna, ci sono un sacco di video fatti direttamente dal dottor Zimbardo che spiegano anche nei dettagli l'esperimento, anche in relazione del caso di Grave, che vi spiegherò poi in inglese tra poco. The Lucifer Effect è stato scritto appunto da Zimbardo e ho linkato in questo documento di Drive un video di 24 minuti che, anche se non lo spiega esattamente tutto, tutto il Lucifer Effect, con anche l'esperimento, con video e testimonianze sia di una guardia sia anche di un carcerato attualmente dell'esperimento. Quindi, incominciando a parlare in inglese, I want to talk about the Stanford Prison Experiment by Dr. Zimbardo. Dr. Zimbardo is a psychologist that conceived this experiment since he, when he was little, asked himself, why do people become evil? The answer is still the same today. People doesn't become evil. In the society, we usually say that one born is evil, and then they continue to be evil in the rest of their life because they have a monstrosity in them that leads them to do some harmful and dangerous thing to other individuals. So, as I wrote, Zimbardo wrote the Lucifer Effect after he did a really unethical experiment. That was the Stanford Prison Experiment. Stanford is a university that had a big basement. And this basement became a prison, a fake prison, obviously. And they took part to the experiment. Took part to the experiment. 24 students that were randomly chosen to be to play the role of guards and prisoners. So the experiment had to be as real as possible, and so the prisoners and the guards were given the uniforms to the policemen were given the sunglasses, and to the guards also they were given some fake guns. To the prisoners, we because of their hairs, they were given a sock to take on their heads. In order to fake the they have no hair. So I have a video where Zimbardo explains how did he did the experiment and why he started to worry about himself.
The psychology department of Stanford University. A mock prison was created. It rivaled all social psychology experiments in controversy.
Shortly after I finished this Stanford prison study, Milgram embraced me and said, I'm so happy that you did this. He said, because now you can take off some of the heat that he's had to bear the load of having done the most unethical study.
So as Zimbardo says, he was friends with Milgram, that made another test that one of my classmates explained some days ago. And he was so happy that Zimbardo decided to do such an unethical experiment because it was still legal in the time that psychologists can experiment on people in even a sadistic way, ISA. And in that way, Milgram felt really reassured that even another psychologist did these things to other students.
grave, it was eerie. People were being told to other Iraqis that wouldn't cooperate. I mean, they're torturing, they're abusing detainees. They're looking at the situation thinking, they've condoned this, but why? And if it wouldn't have been for those photos, no one would have ever believed.
Something happened. Zimbardo talked about bad acts. quantity. And he is a bad apple. But he asked, what will happen if we took good apples and we take them to a bad barrel, or in another way, what will happen if we took good people, intelligent and morally respectful people, to a bad situation? And in the first day, it seems that nothing was going to happen, but in the other few days, something really shocking happened. Zimbardo played the role of the jail director, so he was even a part of the experiment. And the things that happened were really, really similar to Abu Ghraib prison, where some American soldiers did some horrible and awful things to the Iraqi prisoners. Because they felt in charge. So power is the first thing that can draw people to act differently from their usual moral and society in general rules. So the first day passed pretty normal, and the first day we saw that the prisoner was starting mocking the guards, giggling, and they even set up a sort of revolution where they barricaded them inside their cells, and they were harassing the guards. And the guards felt like real security guards. And in that point, at that point, the security guards began to feel morally offended. So they started to act as real security guards and started to harass and even offend the French students that now are real prisoners. They were treated as normal prisoners that done very awful things to go to jail. And they started to call them with their numbers. They make them do some awful things that in the prison of Abu Ghraib, the American soldiers did in a in like 30 days or less. In 3 days here, there was an escalation of authority and power that made the security guards do really awful things to these poor prisoners. And some of them didn't even thought anymore that it was an experiment. They thought they were imprisoned, and they couldn't say, stop, I want to go home, because they could do that, because Dr. Zimbardo was always listening. The experiment was meant to last for 2 weeks, but at the sixth day, the experiment was shut down because the events were going really, really bad. They made them do sexually offending things, such as touching themselves and saying, I love you, to another prisoner. And so they make them do also embarrassing things, things that when they were in the university or at their home, they didn't even think to do. So, what happened in the sixth day? In the sixth day, Zimbardo's girlfriend went to him to watch what he was doing, and he explained to her what was his experiment about, and unfortunately, she started to see what the security guards were doing to the prisoners. They were the security guards were making the prisoners do push-ups with other prisoners on their back, and this was a really shocking fact to the father's girlfriend, which is the psychologist that talked to some minutes ago in the video. And she said, look at what you're doing, look at what you're doing to these poor guys that are just university students. And at that point, Zimbabwe had an epiphany. He thought that he wasn't a psychologist anymore, but he was a jail a jail director. He wasn't acting as a person who studied and who was doing an experiment, but he was acting as someone that had to make in the prison order again. And this was happening even to the security guards. So this effect is called the Lucifer effect, which I explained briefly at the end of the page. Here I also find some summed up record of the experiment, and I pasted it in here. But you can find more details in the link that I put on Stanford Prison Experiment. So I was asking before, the Lucifer effect. What is the Lucifer effect? The Lucifer effect is an effect that three factors made on an individual can make him change from bad to good, even if there's not a solid line between bad and good. There's always something in between. So, as I'm saying here, Zimbardo thinks that when he decided to do this experiment in the university, something really amazing happened. These three factors lined up and created the perfectly caused theory that is the Lucifer effect. So we have a dispositional factor, which is the bad apple, as I was saying before, or the individual along with his will, his tendency, and his behavior. So the person that means the security guard, that in the that in situation means I am the guard. I have the power to make these people shut up and make these people do what I want. Then there is the situational factor, that is the bad battle where the devil are winning, which is the situation where the individual is bullied, and which is in Zimbardo's experiment, the set up in the prison. Then it is the systemic factor, which is the most important, and it is the social system that is going to create on a certain situation, which is in fact the prison where the prisoners and the guards were living. So, in conclusion, thanks to this the Lucifer effect, we know that people doesn't born being evil, but the people can become evil if put in a situation where we give them power, or even if the situation they are living is really stressful. And in that way, the importance of a psychologist is really exciting. And with that, I conclude my explanation of this Zimbardo Stanford Prison Experiment.
Okay, grazie.